Mr. Luck here, and welcome to lesson 2 of the Wolverhampton Music Service music making videos. We've got a number of activities lined up for you today where we'll have you singing, listening, and dancing. And I hope that you'll have lots of fun whilst learning with us. Whether you're at home or at school, there are plenty of activities to get involved with either your classmates or your family. If you missed our first video, please feel free to check that out as well, as it has loads of fun activities for you to get involved with. I'm here again with my team, which is me, Phaedra.
Hi.
Mrs. Barrett.
Hello.
And Paul.
Hello.
And we're all super excited to take you through this week's activities. So, in today's lesson, we're going to start with Paul, who's going to take us through a guitar dancing warm-up. And I can't wait to get involved in that. Then Mrs. Barrett is going to take us through a song called Let Me See You Boogaloo, which will be followed by Phaedra, who's going to do a lovely listening exercise with you. And I hope you've got your listening ears ready. Finally, we'll get on to our Instrument of the Week segment, where you'll learn all about a brand new instrument from one of our experts. So, without further ado, because I can't wait any longer, let's get writing about it.
Hi guys, are you ready to sing and dance with me? I hope so. This song's called Get Up, Get Down and Move It All Around. It's really easy and it goes like this. Are you ready? First line goes, get up, get down, and move it all around. And again, get up, get down, and move it all around. Here we go, together, come on. You're moving and grooving and you're sounding great. Remember guys, the safety in schools. Remember to keep your distance. Remember no shouting. Maybe just try some solos. One person stands up, has a little sing, then sits down. It's easy, okay? Let's try a new part now, shall we? This part involves your elbows. Now we know we shouldn't be high-fiving, but an elbow bump, that's okay, I think, all right? New part goes like this. Elbow with someone. Elbow with someone. Elbow with someone. Elbow with someone. Wow. Oh, yes. Okay, guys. Let's put the whole song together with the ups and the downs and the rounds and the elbows. Let's make sure we throw in some actions, guys, because I can't see us dancing. Are you dancing at home? Hope so. So this time, when we sing get up, hand in the air. When we sing get down to the ground. When we sing move it all around, you got to do a little boogie like this, little boogie round like this. Looks super cool, all right? Let's try the whole song. Are you ready? Here we go. 1, 2, 3, come on. Let up, get down, and move it. my own. You guys just listen really carefully. And this time, whatever I sing, you guys do. So if I sing get up, you guys get up. If I sing get down, you guys get down. Sounds pretty easy, right? Let's find out, ready? So just me singing, here we go. The actions, come on. Get up. Voices were working and your bodies were moving and your brains exploded. Well done, guys. Let's crack on with our next activity.
Hi, everyone. We're going to do a song called Let Me See You Boogaloo. In this piece of music, we need to pretend that we're playing different instruments. We've got a keyboard, we've got drums, we've got a sax, or a saxophone, we've got a double bass, and we've got a banjo. In this piece of music, you need to be able to say, what's that you say, after I say my line. So let's practice now. I'm going to go, let me see you boogaloo, and you have to go, what's that you say? Try that with me. Let me see you boogaloo. What's that you say? I'm going to say each line of the music and I'd like you to join in with Mrs. Barrett too with the what's that you say. Here we go, let's get started. Let me see you boogaloo. What's that you say? I said, let me see you boogaloo. What's that you say? Booga 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 boogaloo. Boogie booga 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 boogaloo. Let me see you play the drums. What's that you say? I said, let me see you play the drums. What's that you say? Rum-ti-tum, rum-ti-tum, rum-ti-tum-tum. Rum-ti-tum, rum-ti-tum, rum-ti-tum-tum. Let me see you play the sax. What's that you say? I said, let me see you play the sax. What's that you say? Scooby-dooby-dooby, scooby-doo-da. Scooby-dooby-dooby, scooby-doo-da. Let me see you play the bass. What's that you say? I said, let me see you play the bass. What's that you say? A dum 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 dooby doo da. Dum 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 dooby doo da. Let me see you play banjo. What's that you say? I said, let me see you play banjo. What's that you say? Blinky blonk, blinky blonk, blinky blonk blonk. Blinky blonk, blinky blonk, blinky blonk blonk. In that piece of music, there were five different instruments. Can you remember what they all were? Let's see if you can remember them now. Number one. Number two. Number three. Number four. And number five. It doesn't matter which order you said them in, but there is a keyboard, drums, saxophone, double bass, and a banjo.
There's a different character to the sound of each of those instruments, and that's called the timbre. It's a bit like how you can recognise the voice of a friend if they come up behind you.
Have a listen to the sound of these different voices.
Hello, it's me.
This is my voice.
Hello, it's me.
Everyday sounds have their own timbre too. Can you recognise these different sounds?
Let's see if you got those right. Well done. We're going to listen to the five instruments now from Let Me See You Boogaloo, and I'd like you to see if you can recognise each of the instruments from the different timbres of the sound. Well done. That was great listening.
Thanks, Mrs. Barrett. That was so much fun with the Boogaloo. Girls and boys, are you ready to play a little game with me now? Just a little quiz. 10 questions. And all you've got to do is identify the instruments that I'm going to play for you. So switch your listening ears on. Okie doke. And let's have a listen and see if you can name the instrument. Are you ready? Here goes. Some jazz on that recorder. How cool is that? Lovely, well done. Right, let's see if we can guess the next instrument.
Mm-hmm.
Did you get it? What is it? I can't hear you. What was it? That's correct. It's a Glockenspiel. Well done. Didn't it sound beautiful? Let's move on to our next instrument. Let's have a listen closely. Oh, girls and boys, that went low there, didn't it? Right, what instrument was that? Have a think. Can you guess? It was. Well done. It was a trombone. Brilliant. You guys are so good at this. Did you get it? It was only one instrument, but lots of different sounds going on at the same time. An interesting timbre there. What was it? Think. You might hear one of these in a church. That's correct. It was an organ. Well done. Fantastic. Right, let's move on to our next instrument. Listen ears on. That was a, let's hear you say it, a saxophone. Well done. It was a saxophone. You are doing so good. Let's have a listen to the next one. Listening ears on. Are you ready? Right then, guys, what was that one? I know what it made me think of, but was I right? It was an oboe. Okay, an oboe. It sounded so light and like little fairies dancing around the field. Well, that's what it sounded like to me anyway. I thought that was beautiful. Well done if you got that one right. Here we go. Let's have a listen to the next one. Did you get it? That one was easier, wasn't it, that one? Yes, that's right. It was a piano. Well done. This one might be a little bit more tricky. It seemed like there were a lot of things going on in that one. Could you hear lots of different sounds being made? I wonder what instrument it was. Any ideas? The drums? No. Trumpet? No. I wonder. Shall I tell you? It was the voice. One man making all those sounds from his voice. That is called beatboxing. You might be able to do a little bit by going Have a try. See what sounds you can make with your voice using your tongue, your throat, okay? See what you can do. That's so cool. So that's beatboxing. Well done if you got that one right though. I was playing a trick on you there. Let's move on. Have a listen to this and see if you can tell me what instrument is next. Did you get it? Are you right? That's correct. It was a guitar. Well done. That was fantastic. Lovely. Right, let's see if you can get this one. There might be two instruments, but they are the same instrument. Okay, so there's a little clue for you. Have a listen. What was it? What instrument? Come on. It was the cello. Well done if you got that. Girls and boys, you've done fantastic listening. Give yourselves a round of applause or a high five. And if you got every single instrument right, I am so proud of you. And if you didn't, don't worry. I'm still so proud of you. You are all amazing. Doing your best at listening. So lots of different sounds there. And you may have found your favourite instrument in one of those sounds, or you may have thought, I'd quite like to have a go at playing one of those. So what I'm doing is setting you a challenge. I want you to pop on to the internet with your parents or with an adult and have a listen to lots of different instruments. Maybe if you've got a couple of instruments at home, you might want to have a little play on them. You might have to ask if they're not yours though, okay? And it might be that you find a new instrument that you want to learn. How cool would that be? Well done. Good listening ears. And I hope you've had lots of fun today.
Wow. Thank you, Phaedra and Suzanne. That was amazing. I never knew all those instruments could sound so different to one another. I'll be listening very carefully in future every time I hear a new piece of music. We're now going to pass on to Liam, who's going to tell us all about his instrument of the week, which is the alto saxophone.
So the alto saxophone belongs to a family of instruments called the woodwind family. It's mainly made out of metal, but actually in order to make a sound on the saxophone, you need to be able to blow down through this black part here, which is called the mouthpiece, and it's made out of plastic. And that vibrates with this small piece of wood here called the reed. So that's how you make a sound on the saxophone. And to finish off, I'm just going to play a short rendition of a really famous tune called The Pink Panther.
Thank you very much. And that brings us to the end of this lesson. We danced, we got up and down and moved it all around with Paul. And then we did the boogaloo with Mrs. Barrett and some fantastic listening exercises with Mrs. Barrett and then with Phaedra. And we finally got to see an alto saxophone. I know that I am going to do some listening to lots of instruments this week, and I hope you do the same. And I hope that you'll also join us in the next lesson. But for now, see you later.